One Hot Copy Halal and 2013 series. Historically, he's got to be the only and first candidate to actually win a Senate seat, we'd have to say, while detained or in jail. Now, Senator Antonio Trillanes is running for re-election in the midterm polls, and his campaign centers on his platform of fighting corruption in government. What has Senator Antonio Trillanes done in the last few years?
He made history in 2007 for being the first senator to be elected while in jail, backed by 11 million votes. He has filed bills supporting the Philippine Veterans Authority Act and price controls. This year, Senator Antonio Trillanes IV is running for re-election under the administration coalition senatorial ticket. He's in the magic 12 in recent surveys. Time and again, the controversial senator has also been hogging the headlines for his controversial statements. Some observers believe his dressing down of a senior officer, the late Defense Secretary Angelo Reyes, during a 2011 Senate hearing over alleged irregularities in the military when he was still AFP Chief of Staff, may have been among the reasons why Reyes took his own life. A vocal critic of Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile, Trillanes has been working for Enrile's removal from the Senate leadership. Trillanes bolted the Senate majority last year, accusing Enrile of railroading the division of Camarines Sur on former President Arroyo's orders. In turn, Enrile accused him of siding with the Chinese in back-channel talks on the Philippines' territorial row over the Scarborough Shoal. These days, Trillanes is calling on government to bear its policy on the Sabah claim. Trillanes also criticizes Enrile's handling of the Senate's discretionary funds. He also disputes a commission on audit report, saying he was a top spender among the senators in 2011.
All right, that was a good primer. Joining us on Hot Coffee, Team Pinoy senatorial candidate Antonio Trillanes is with us this morning. Senator, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen.
All right, 11 million votes in 2007 without having to campaign a single day outside. Mm-hmm. People say that was an anti-GMA vote. They admired what you stood for against GMA. Mm-hmm. In the years you've been sitting as a senator, was it worth it for the people that they voted for you?
I believe so. I believe that I have lived up to the mandate that was given to me, and that I performed my functions as defined. And I'll have to elaborate a few of my accomplishments as well.
Uh-oh.
We've been one of the most productive legislators in terms of number of bills filed.
Okay.
And in terms of number of sponsored bills, national bills, and in terms of number of hearings conducted.
Yes, because people don't know this about you. They've always called you arrogant, although they do call you courageous and brave. Mm-hmm. But along with that comes the arrogant factor.
Probably it's because I am young and I'm quite transparent. I'm quite passionate. They don't really know me personally and socially. I think that's where the wrong perception is coming from.
Because you don't smile.
In public.
No, you really don't.
In public.
Okay, but you really don't.
yes, because it's a serious work. Right?
Okay.
And every time the media would be interviewing me, it's about a very serious issue. So, it's not, there's no reason to smile.
Okay. All right. During the time you've been senator, for our viewers to know, is you're the fourth most productive senator. There were 31 bills that you filed that actually are authored, passed into law. Authored or filed?
Yes.
Okay. 734 bills and resolutions filed, but in the same breath, you were also quoted or touted as being one of the biggest spenders in the Senate. In 2011, they said you were one of the biggest spenders. What do they mean by that?
You see, every senator has the same budget allocation.
Okay. For the...
For the whole year.
PIDAF, MOOE, whatever.
Yes.
Okay.
Except for the oversight.
Okay.
But if you include the oversight, then I am the least spender, one of the least spenders, I think.
Okay, define oversight for the public.
There is an oversight committee. It's it's not part of, it's different from the ones being audited by the COA.
Okay.
The COA audits the office of the senator and the regular committees.
Okay.
But they don't audit the oversight committees as part of their computation per senator. But if they include that, then I am the least spender.
Okay.
But as far as the regular committees and my office are concerned, I have the most number of employees because I filled up the quota.
Uh-oh.
I filled up the plantilla positions.
Yes.
And that's the thing. If you fill it up, then you won't have any savings.
Then you have no point for corruption.
Yes, yeah. Precisely.
But as people for don't see that.
Yes, but as for the others, they have an allocation for salaries, but they don't fill it up. So they have savings. And what they do is they request for realignment of the savings to MOOE.
Which is very flexible.
Yes, so they don't return this money. So when the COA would come up with a report about how everything is spent, I think the more you get to spend and that is audited by COA, it means that's less corruption.
Okay. I'm going to ask you this. The COA came out with a report that in 2009, Senator Jinggoy Estrada's PDAF of 110 million went to a bogus NGO for that year. Mm-hmm. Kay Enrile was 77 million and I think Bong Revilla 10 million. Mm-hmm. Do you believe that they did not know that it did not go to any project, that they did not know it was a bogus NGO?
That's impossible. I think, well, they need to defend themselves later on because I think I heard Senator Jinggoy Estrada calling for an investigation, which I hope they would also abstain from joining to avoid conflict of interest. But it's impossible. Based on my experience, when you get to approve the projects for your PDAF, you get to scrutinize whether the project is worthwhile and the proponents of the project, the local government units involved.
Now, paano kumikita ang mga congressman at senador? This is generally sa stilong ito. Kasi ang tagal mong sundalo eh. So siguro nagulat ka yung pamamalakad na when you are a legislator. So paano, how do they do it?
I think, well, I can only speculate. I can only speculate that some unscrupulous individuals may be coming up with an offer.
Yes,
to,
I heard this.
Yes, so
sa Senate.
The bigger the allocation for a certain project,
the bigger the cut.
I think that's the opening. That's where the opening would come from.
Now, have you kept yourself free from temptation? Or a contractor may come up and say, ano kayo, si Trillanes gets 30% of everything.
Well, they can check. I think Senator Enrile has done the spade work already, whether I was doing that, and he came up empty. And I think the key here is to distribute it to as many LGUs as possible. So it doesn't make sense if for example, I allocated 2 million to a certain municipality and I'll get, how much, 400,000 for that?
Oh, parang yun na yun.
So,
That's one way to avoid
way.
Corruption.
But if you allocate it...
A big amount
for
Let's
a certain...
Let's say arm.
Yes.
But puro arm yun eh.
Whether, I don't know.
Oh, 50 million arm.
50 million or
arm.
100 million, then... That's where you can say commissions can be transacted.
Yeah. All right. Mm-hmm. Now, Ernie Maceda, when he was on the show, said the problem with the Senate today, the pork barrel and the budget is just way too big.
Way too big? No, that's not the problem. The problem is in the individual senator.
Okay.
So that's why it's very important in these elections to vote for character.
Define character.
Well, the incorruptibility of the candidate and the tendency to abuse the position. Because some senators, they use their position as senator to shake down businessmen. they will shake you down to get, let's say, shares of stock or money, so that they won't harass you, they won't subject you to a committee hearing. So that's what they do. So the public, the voting public, should have to scrutinize whether these candidates have the tendency to be abusive and to really use their power or abuse their power to harass individuals.
All right. Now, clearly, one of the pluses is you're a straight shooter. You were the only one who had the guts to actually go against Enrile and question him regarding the Kamsur division. Okay, that never happened. Okay. And after that, you were one of those at some point punished, and you had no additional MOOE of 1.3 million. Was it, the COA has said he has the discretion to choose where the money will go, the savings will go. Do you agree with that?
Yes, legally that's the case. But which is precisely why I didn't question the discrepancy or the disparity, because that's part of the deal. If you go against the Senate president, an abusive one at that, you'll have to, there's a downside to that. And in this case, the perks and privileges will be removed.
But would you consider Enrile abusive?
Most definitely. And he has a long history to reinforce that that claim. And that's my complaint.
But they've said that they've given you an oversight committee, which would mean that you do, you know what I mean? You have extra responsibilities. That's an extra budget for staff and whatever. You know what I mean? Yes. So, ang point of the Enrile camp, and I remember Attorney Gigi Reyes pointing this out when she got very upset on DZMM with you and Alan Cayetano, is you do have, I mean, Enrile was, in other words, granting more or less, he was democratic.
That's what they said. And their credibility is precisely in question, right? Okay, this is what they did not tell everybody.
Okay.
They tried to remove all these things.
All? Your committee? Your committee chairmanships?
Yes,
and
the oversight. The, and when I crossed him, he tried to remove as many privileges and benefits that a senator could possibly have. And that's it just shows how vindictive, how abusive and dictatorial the senator really is. And people should not be surprised, because their older the older generation are supposed to is supposed to know him much more than I do.
Okay. All right. Now, when it comes to track record, Ramon Montaño was here, and among Enrile, Onasan, and yourself, he's only pleased with your performance. Let's go down to basics. What have you done for soldiers?
Okay, the AFP modernization law.
May pera ba to? May pondo?
But that's the main grievance that we had, one of the principal grievances that we have back in 2003. And we have come full circle now.
Okay.
That before, we're complaining about antiquated equipment and so on. But now that I was given the chance to make a difference and do something about it, we pushed. I was a principal author of that, of course, along with Senator Lacson.
How come you're really shy when you're talking about the bills you filed? Dapat dito ka ano?
I have this thing about self-promotion.
Okay.
I would have wanted people
to know,
to scrutinize by themselves.
All right.
Instead of us promoting ourselves, and it's, if that's the case, then it's going to be a function of who has the better PR machinery.
Okay. So you are one of the principal authors of the AFP modernization law, along with Senator Lacson. And can soldiers feel this today?
They are feeling it right now. We have procured several equipment under the Aquino administration, as compared to the past 9 years of GMA, not a single modern equipment was procured. And aside from that, we also pushed for...
I'm curious, like, what was procured during Pinoy's? I mean, I'm just curious.
The helicopters. Yes, and we have patrol boats.
Okay.
I visited the Philippine Fleet headquarters, and they paraded the new boats. So, and aside from that, we were one of the principal authors of the salary standardization law that increased the salaries of soldiers, policemen, teachers, and all the government employees.
From?
That doubled their salary.
Yeah, that's a big deal.
Yes. And I also pushed for the increase of the subsistence allowance, quarters allowance, and all these things that only a former soldier would know. So I, being their voice in the Senate, I pushed for the upliftment of their morale and welfare. And that's also precisely one of the reasons why some propagandists are trying to destroy me by peddling this lie that I filed this bill, retirement bill, that will be detrimental to the interests of the soldiers. So that's a complete lie. I never filed that bill along. They're blaming Senator Legarda and myself for
this text.
And
yeah.
That's not true. That's a lie. And they're even distributing this propaganda materials inside camps. So I think we have to put a stop to that. Whoever is the senatorial candidate behind this black propaganda should just promote himself positively. And not
so. Who's behind it?
We have some Senator Legarda and I have been talking about it, and we're trying to narrow down
the usual suspects.
Yes. Here's the thing: if you want to get elected in the Senate, then just show the people what you're capable of doing.
Okay. So who's behind it? Who's behind the black propaganda?
I really can't say.
Okay, all right. I thought you were going to say. Okay, all right. Now, we have some photos. Are we ready for that? I want to show some photos, and all you need to do is describe, okay? Then we go to parts of the interview. All right, let's start with that. Here, you have to look there.
Okay.
Describe.
He's Secretary of Foreign Affairs.
No, that's it. That's a fact. Okay. I need a description.
Okay.
Go. The truth. Go.
I don't know. I'm blank. I'm blank.
You're careful.
Yes. Yes.
What about the first thing that comes into your mind?
I respect the president.
So you are not okay?
What?
You and Del Rosario.
We don't have to be best friends, right? But all of us are behind the president as far as foreign policy is concerned.
Now, are you satisfied with how the president and Secretary Del Rosario so far have been dealing with the West Philippine Sea issue? Because I don't think we have... Do we have an ambassador already to China?
Yes, yes.
A new one after Sonia Brady?
Yes.
Okay. So after that, are you satisfied with how we've built ties?
I'm satisfied with how the president steered everything, including the Sabah standoff.
You don't think he mishandled Sabah?
It's still unfolding. It's still unfolding. We're trying to provide as much input as we can to the
president.
Are
you the backdoor negotiator
to
Sabah? Because you're not.
No.
But are you sure?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so you're satisfied with how Pinoy handled Sabah? I mean, saying the word surrender, we're filing cases. I mean, the truth as a soldier.
There were some missteps.
Missteps.
But this can be rectified. And we can't go back now. We could have, and we would have preferred that no Filipino blood have been shed, but that's done now.
But what should we do with our claim to Sabah?
I believe we should pursue it. We should pursue the claim, at least the proprietary rights of the Sultanate. And right now, the immediate concern is the protection of the Filipino citizens in Sabah.
Should the administration file cases against the Kiram Group?
Not at this point. I think there's no crime committed, as far as I'm concerned. they should be more, they should focus their aggression, or the foreign policy should focus on the protection of the Filipino lives there, whether they belong to the Kiram followers or the ordinary Filipino migrant workers there.
All right, okay, next photo. Ah, okay, so that was part of the photos, okay. I know, all right, next. Oh, Maestro Campo.
Yes, he's one of the core leaders of our group.
Why are you stating me facts? Describe nga ang rule of the game.
he was a friend. He was a friend, and I look forward to renewing those
yes.
ties.
That's the reason our EP chose that photo, because we know that your ties with the Magdalo Group are not okay.
His ties. Not my,
yours. Yeah, so. Okay, but are you and Maestro Campos speaking?
Not at the moment, but we're looking forward to that day that we'll be able to set aside those differences.
And, what was the major fight?
It's just a disagreement in approach to the whole dilemma at the time.
Okay, all right. Next. Danny Lim, describe.
Again, blank. You're giving me.
Why? Danny Lim was one of your major supporters in the past.
Let's just say that I got to know him. And that very. That's the reason why I got to change my impression of him.
Now, Danny Lim, my sources tell me, is campaigning against you.
Yes.
This doesn't look good.
On him, probably.
But what happened? Why is it, I mean, Senator, that former core members or supporters that you used to have, you are not in good ties with?
No, these are exceptions you're pointing out, because the Magdalo Group is largely intact, almost 95% intact, and they're still with us. So it's not fair to say that I've been at odds with everybody. Of course not.
Okay. Just in Rile. No, I'm kidding. All right, so you're not at odds with everybody. But with Danny Lim, what happened?
Let's just say that we had irreconcilable differences of principles.
Is it a corruption issue?
I can't comment further.
Ba? Iba ka na ngayon, ha? Dati, lagi ka madali ka mag-comment. Next. Describe.
Senator Nasan is an upperclassman and a friend.
A friend.
Yes.
Now, Montano on the show yesterday was brave enough to say his point of view that he believed Gringo is the mastermind and behind the death of Olalia. Do you believe that?
I'm not privy, because I think I was in high school then at that time.
But are you satisfied with Gringo's performance?
Yes, in the Senate. Yes, he's one of the more productive senators there.
But isn't he like the ultimate yes man to Enrile, they say?
I don't know about that. I'm just looking at the performance per se of the senator, as a senator, as a legislator. So,
your friends.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. Next. Nag-iingat. Mahirap. Okay. Next. Oh.
Secretary Angelo Reyes was an upperclassman, and it was just unfortunate that we had this sad encounter.
Yeah. Now, do you feel guilty? Or have you ever blamed yourself that there are stories that part of the reason he committed suicide was because you humiliated him and dressed him down so completely in that Senate hearing that he couldn't recover? Have you blamed yourself?
No, I've reflected on that particular incident a lot of times. I don't have any regrets, but I do learned a lot of lessons at that time. And I think that's not the reason
Why? Meaning you are not the reason.
Yes, that incident was not the reason why Secretary Angelo Reyes took his own life. I think he had deeper reasons than that. And only God knows at this point. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. You think there is no more corruption, frankly, in the AFP? I mean, now with Pinoy, is there? Or you don't want to be idealistic?
I think it was drastically reduced.
Okay.
Drastically reduced.
But meron?
Very, very minimal. Compared to before. Right now, even the lifestyle of the senior officers have drastically changed.
Okay.
And that's the principal indicator of the state of corruption in the armed forces.
All right, we're going to take a quick break. When we return, he's going to breathe for a while. We'll continue our conversation. You should show this. It's like he's literally. Team Pinoy senatorial candidate Antonio Trillanes. Mukhang this is the new Trillanes. Hot copy, we'll be right back. All right, Senator Antonio Trillanes is with us this morning. Does he merit another Senate seat? Okay, we'll continue first with the pictures. I find the pictures game of Head Start extremely revealing to all our candidates. Okay, I mean, some people have cried on the show with some pictures. Next picture. Describe, wag mo sabihing former president.
he used to be an ally. He is an ally.
Until now? Yes, your ally?
No, not now.
Okay. Why did you say ERAP was an ally?
Because during the struggle against the GMA, all of us were working together.
Okay. Yeah. Now, there are reports that ERAP and Laarni Enriquez funded part of the Oakwood Mutiny.
Probably. I wouldn't know.
Really?
Yes.
Probably.
I wouldn't know.
Meaning you personally wouldn't know, but the talk could be true that they must have supported.
Yes. Probably. I don't have personal knowledge about the matter, so I wouldn't know.
But would that be a crime if they supported financially?
Supposed to be. But I think we've gone past that now.
Okay. All right. Next photo. Oh, tama. Laarni. Siya galing nila. Have you ever met her?
Yes, I met her after I got out. She's a friend. She's a very nice lady.
Okay. So to be fair, you are friends with Laarni Enriquez. You were in touch.
Now, after I got out.
Okay.
Yes.
So
I met her a couple of times.
Did she help support your Senate campaign in 2007?
No, not her personally.
I
wouldn't know indirectly or directly.
Okay. So clearly, I mean, did ERAP support you then?
Yes.
Okay. So paano ngayon to, you're not in UNA? LP ka ba? LP ka, no?
I'm with the Nacionalista Party,
you're right,
with
NP.
With Team Pinoy.
Okay. Because NP coalesced also with Team Pinoy. All right, next.
He's,
you did say abusive.
Yes, it's just tragic that he wasted 50 years of public service abusing people. And he can't possibly undo that now.
But didn't Enrile get the admiration of many because of the impeachment trial?
You see, that's a facade. All of us know what really happened during the caucuses,
What really happened?
There's a big story behind that.
Was it really, really helping Renato Campos, with Corona's camp?
There were information to that effect until it became untenable for him to sustain that acquittal track. And that's why probably they turned.
Now, you had said that Enrile would be replaced as Senate President, and it never happened.
I didn't say he would be. I wished, that's my wish. But what I said what I told the public was, we're short of the Liberal Party senators. Our numbers would be short of the Liberal Party. But if the Liberal Party senators would join us, then he would have been replaced. But apparently, based on their assessment, it would be more prudent to let him finish this 15th Congress as okay. Senate President.
All right. Now, two Enriles in the Senate. What would that be like for you?
It's not going to be my problem. It's going to be the problem of some people that they would want to cross or who crossed this Enrile family. Yeah.
But aren't you alarmed already that the Senate is like a family business?
Mm.
I mean, when I say business, I'm not insinuating they're corrupt, but I'm saying family members are in the Senate together. Mm-hmm. Two Cayetanos, at one point you had two Estradas, mother and son. Now you're going to have two Estradas, most mm-hmm. likely, mm-hmm. a brother and brother, and then you might have father and son. I mean, frankly speaking, it's ridiculous.
I don't look at the surnames.
Okay.
I'm looking at the service. I think the Cayetanos are doing okay. They have served well in their capacity as senators, Senator Pia and Senator Alan. And even the prospect of having Congressman JV becoming senator doesn't bother me because I know Congressman JV performed well as mayor of the of San Juan.
But they can be a powerful block in the Senate. That's the problem. There are only 24 seats in the Senate, and then two people can be one big vote changer for major bills.
Yeah. So, but we'll just have to suspend our judgment regarding that. But if you're an incumbent senator like Senator Alan, you have to look at his track record, mm-hmm. his voting record, mm-hmm. and that should be the basis for re-election. Mm-hmm. And as far as newcomers like Congressman JV, you would have to judge him based on what he has done in his previous capacities.
Okay, all right. Okay, all right, next. So clearly you will not support an anti-dynasty bill.
No,
you won't.
It's a distraction.
The political dynasty bill?
Yes, we have to focus not on the surnames. Because even in the United States, they have
the
dynasties.
Kennedys,
yes.
And the Clintons.
In fact, they're looking for that brand. So the basis is the public service track
brand
record.
Of
yes,
the
brand. Oh.
By argument.
So in our case, you have to look at the public service record, the potential for corruption of these people, these individuals. So a good surname may be good for name recall, but later on you have to scrutinize on the character of that individual.
All right, next photo, next photo.
Senator Lacson, like Senator Honasan, is an upperclassman and a friend.
A friend. Ang dami palang ano, no? PMA?
Yeah.
Sa Senado?
We're only three. We're only three
lang? Okay. All right. So, Lacson, describe him. Other than friend.
Yes, he's one of the most productive senators of the land, and he's one of the straight shooters. He's an advocate of so many issues.
Was it right for him to evade arrest? He was a fugitive.
That was his personal judgment based probably on his safety or the sense of justice that he might get or not get. So that was his judgment call.
Okay, next.
Vice President Bina, he, like President Estrada, he used to be an ally.
Okay, now you're not speaking?
Probably because both of us are busy.
Yun lang.
Yeah.
Okay, next. Mm-hmm. Used to be an ally. This is against GMA. Mm-hmm. Your wife. Mm-hmm. Is the picture?
Yes. My wife.
Yeah, nga. Describe.
She's a. The best mother in this world. Yeah.
That's it?
Yeah.
So are you still sweet?
Yes. Of course, we're still together.
Now, I want to ask you, divorce, Do you think divorce is, we should consider divorce?
Divorce, no, no. We're not, I think it may complicate or worsen the problem that we wish to solve.
Okay, all right. But when it, you voted for RH. Did you vote for RH?
No.
You did not. So you were anti-RH.
I am anti-RH.
Okay, why were you anti-RH?
Mm-hmm. Because of the sex education component.
That's it.
Yes, I believe that the kids at that age, grade 6 students, the sex education component should be given to the parents and not the state.
Okay, but you were not against the government funding contraception?
That's also another point of contention. They plan to increase the budget allocation for that. I think we would have so many problems at so many levels. First, the corruption side. These are consumable items, expendable items that can easily be corrupted or converted into cash.
All right. Okay. Oh, one more picture. They rushed one more. Last. Mm.
Jimmy, she wasted the opportunity to really serve and serve the country and turn things around for the Filipino people.
Mm, my God, they're enjoying the photos upstairs. Huh? Okay, next. One more down. Mm.
Mike Arroyo, I think it's the same as they wasted it. They wasted 9 years. Trust was given to them initially. They could have used that trust to the betterment of our countrymen. Mm-mm. But
no, I've often heard this about Antonio Trillanes. Yeah, when he has guts, he has courage, he's got, you know, the balls to actually start. But does he really have a plan? I mean, like when you went to Manila Pen, for example, why do that? Many people had asked, and where was the end goal? When you were talking about the coup attempts in the Senate, many said it lacks strategy. Where was the end goal? In other words, people aren't questioning your bravery, but they are questioning your strategic skills.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You see, strategy isn't discussed publicly.
Mm-mm.
Privately, I'll talk to you about the strategy behind all those things. And ultimately, you'll have to look at the results. The events are still unfolding, so you can't say that it has worked or it has failed. Okay, so in time, people will realize the and they'll see for themselves what the strategy was.
Okay, all right. Mang Pandoy is asking, is your salen public? For comparison, share with the public your salen when you first joined the Senate and your latest.
Yes, it's in my website.
Okay, so you have no issue with that?
No issue.
All right.
That.
Now, since you're a legislator, what would you change in the Constitution that would make the economy grow?
I'm open to that argument of lifting or taking out the foreign ownership restrictions.
Okay.
I'm
for land, on land specifically,
on
or
land,
even companies.
In companies, yes. And that should open the country for foreign investment and capital. I'm also open to the removal or the opening up of the maritime industry.
Oh, yeah. All right. Explain that.
Right now, it's we have a restriction in our constitution that only Philippine-owned vessels should be used for our domestic shipping.
Okay.
And that's one of the reasons why the shipping costs are very, very expensive.
Okay.
And most of our ships are antiquated.
Uh-oh.
And that's also the reason why we have so many sea disasters.
Okay. Now, to change this, for example, foreign ownership and maritime, would this be just an amendment in the existing laws?
That's the proposal, that's the approach that...
Or this would be considered literally charter change?
No, not yet.
Not
opening up that we can revise anything.
Yeah,
no.
We
can approach it on a piecemeal basis and have those individual amendments ratified by the people through a plebiscite.
Okay, all right. So why haven't you done even one of them, like opening the maritime industry in the years you've been in office?
We filed bills to that effect, and also the removal of that provision that would subject the senior officers to the commission and appointments.
Okay.
So I believe only the chief of staff and the three service commanders should be subjected to the commission and appointments.
Not anymore the lower level or low ranking.
Yes, because that politicized the whole process, so that they should be insulated from politics.
Okay. All right. Last words. What? Why should people vote for you again? 11 million was a lot of votes, Senator, for 2007 for a guy who was. Who never got a day out of jail then. You think you'll have more than 11 million votes?
I really can't say.
Okay.
I'm just doing my best to present our advocacies, what we have done and what we plan to do. And it's up to the people. I will leave it up to them if they really want me to serve them again in the capacity as Senator of the Republic.
So why should they vote for you again?
They should vote for... They should vote for candidates who have what we say malasakit sa kapwa and sa bayan, and the people who won't be abusive and corrupt, and those who would represent their ideals and aspirations for the country, and the people who can fight for their rights during the times of those oppressiveness, people who can stand up and fight for them.
Okay, so, all right.
Yeah.
On that note, thank you very much, Senator Antonio Trillanes.
Thank you.
Okay, you are number in the Pecos ballot.
I don't buy that. I want people to look for the name.
So you don't
vote
know
for
your
the
number.
Name.
You
vote
don't know
for
the number.
And, no, I don't know the number.
I'm impressed. Really?
Yes.
You don't know your number in the ballot.
I don't know yet.
Okay, all right. Okay, so replay of this interview with Senator Antonio Trillanes. It's 6 p.m. tonight. And since it's a Friday, we'll announce the weekend schedules. And I think that's a good way to end the day is when you choose for a senatorial candidate, go for not only track record, but character above most. Let's get started. Karen Davila. Have a good weekend, everyone.